I am here for reasons. Sometimes in my tears I drown, but I never let it get me down. So when negativity surrounds, I know someday it'll all turn around. Because all my life I've been waiting for, I've been praying for the people to say that we don't wanna fight no more. There'll be no more war, and our children will pay.
About Mutsada, we know from only one person. The adults would remember, Josephus, okay? Josephus, so he's the only one who tells us about Mutsada. So either we believe him or not, but we do not have any other historical source. What does the word Mutsada mean? Mutsada, in Hebrew, it's a fortress. A fortress that Herod the Great built to have a place of refuge, just in case.
Just before we enter into our morning service in our B'nai Mitzvah, what does it represent for us as modern liberal Jews in Marin County in 2013? What does this place mean for us?
Determination.
Joy. Nice. Why joy? Because of what you're doing here, right? Yeah. Imagine 2,000 years ago when the zealots who were here, the Israelites who were here, had no choice. They were at the end of the line and they held out for a very long time, but they were at the end of the line. And compare that to our lives, which are sort of the opposite, but not really. We're not threatened as Jews where we live. In fact, we have more freedom now in our place and now than ever before, than Jews have ever had ever before. We're not threatened. It's very easy to, you know, drive up the road to the synagogue. There's nobody standing in our way, right? Unless you're in traffic, but then we could wait just look at the mountains or the sunshine or something like that. So how were their lives different from ours? And maybe how were they similar? How are they different? How are they similar?
Much more of an everyday struggle just to exist.
For them?
Yeah.
Yeah, for them it was as Jews.
Yeah.
Every day they were confronted with a existential threat, right? For their very existence, right? We don't feel that as Jews, right?
No, but we have the same sense of wanting to belong to the religion and defending
Beautiful.
The religion.
Beautiful. We had that same sense. And that's part of why we're here. That's part of why we're here today, to remind ourselves that they are them, right? They are us and we are them, right? That we're carrying on and holding up what they did, what they fought with their lives for, that we're the inheritors of that. And by coming here today, what does that mean? What does that mean for us and for the future? By choosing to become B'nai Mitzvah today and coming here and praying today, what does that mean?
Never forget.
Pardon me?
Never forget.
Never forget. What else?
We know there's a future going forward.
Yeah, part we know there's a future. Maybe never let it go.
Part
yeah.
of growth.
Yeah. Sometimes for us it's so easy to kind of take for granted the fact that we're Jewish, right? That it'll always be there for us. And it's not, we don't hold fast to it and hold it close just because we're threatened. Why are we Jewish? Why do we hold it close? Not just because we're threatened, but because it's holy and it's incredible. And Judaism has contributed so much to the world and helps us to live more holy lives. It's an incredible contribution to our world and to our lives. It enriches your life. That's beautiful. So we're not only here to survive, right? To declare that we are still here, but we're here to bring holiness and joy and goodness and righteousness into this world and into our lives. So we're here to enhance our lives and to enhance the world and to commit to that. So with that, we're going to say good morning, sun.
Soon.
Soon
to be coming.
Soon to be coming. Some people who are wearing your tallit for the first time. And so I thought we would just stand up and do it together for those of us who have a tallit. And the young people too. So why don't you stand up? And the first thing we do is take, this is called the atara, this part up here. And we have it forward facing us. So it's facing us. Facing us. You guys have that? And you have a big one, so you want to put this, turn that around. Facing you. There you go. I like yours. And we'll join together with the bracha. It ends with the words. You see, you guys have it on there like a cheat sheet, right? It ends with the words, lehitatef batzitzit. And before that, it's kind of the regular blessing. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam. Asher kidshanu b'mitzvotav v'tzivanu lehitatef batzitzit. We kiss each side here. And then just take a minute under. So flip it around. Take a minute underneath. Right, to remind ourselves what we're doing here, to feel your heart, to set a kavanah or an intention for this day and this morning. I've assigned a few parts, and so when I get to them, I'm going to call people to read certain things in addition to the kids leading. So young people, why don't you sit down. We're going to join together on the first page, singing Hinei Ma Tov. It's page 3.
Mother Rachel, your children have come home. Home, such a foreign word to the refugee from Argentina. The Vishnitsky Shosit,
the Jew from Bulgarian cities, and that you are home. I feel steel across the border is
the stuff of Jewish lullabies. When the plains at Lot crowd with long lost sons and daughters, truth and freedom blur near disbelief. Tiberias and Gubernia, raise your voices. Masada, burst your rocks with songs, for we are home.
And on the next page, page 4, at the top of the page, I'm going to invite Natasha to read this for you. This was Elazar Ben Yair's speech on the top of Masada, and I would love for you to read that for us. Please.
My loyal followers, long ago, we resolved to serve neither the Romans nor anyone else, but only God, who alone is the true and righteous Lord of men. Now the time has come that bids us prove our determination by our deeds. As such a time as we must not disgrace ourselves. Hitherto we have never submitted to slavery, even when it brought no danger with it. We must not choose slavery now, and with it the penalties that will mean the end of everything we fall alive into the hands of the Romans. For we were the first of all to revolt, and shall be the last to break off the struggle. And I think it is God who has given us this privilege that we can die nobly and as free men, unlike others who were unexpectedly defeated. In our case, it is evident that daybreak will end our resistance, but we are free to choose an honorable death with our loved ones. This our enemies cannot prevent, however earnestly they may pray to take us alive, nor can we defeat them in battle.
Is a prayer of gratitude. So I want us all to just find something inside we're grateful for. And with that inside, we join together singing Mode Ani.
Mode Ani Lefanecha Melech HaVekayam Rabba Emunateha.
And I invite the five of you to come forward to join us in Ashrei. You guys want to step on? You're good. And we'll join together page 4 on the bottom.
Who's A and who's B?
A. A. And you're B. Okay. Ashrei
Yoshvei Beitecha. Oli Halum Hasela. Ashrei ha'am shekahalo, Ashrei ha'am she'adonai Elohav. Next page. Take it out of the devil. Armin paru ha'amalech, Baruch ha'ashim ha'lelam ba'ed, Be'ayol yom ha'archecha, Be'alashim ha'lelam ba'ed, Be'adol Adonai ne'vlo'no, Ve'lidulato e'in chiker,
for daily miracles. Sometimes we don't always recognize that these things are actual miracles, but they are, and this helps us to remember that. And we join together. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, who has given the mind the ability to distinguish day from night.
Baruch Atarunai, Elohim Melech Haolam, who opens the eyes of the blind. Amen. We all say, Brichu, Le'elam in kol berchata v'shirata, Tushbechata v'nechemata, Da'amiram be'alma v'imru. Amen. Say everybody rise, please.
Please rise.
And face towards Yerushalayim, this way for Baruch Hu. La 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 la. Shema Yisrael.